The Great War is infamously known as an extremely brutal conflict, mixing traditional classic warfare with the deadly machines of modern war to kill the enemy at a much greater rate and with a terrific result. World War I is also almost always portrayed in books and film as the muddy hell of the Western Front. However, today we are going to take a different approach and take a look at the African front of World War I, a front that is very rarely seen. Hello and welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to look into the uniforms and kit of the colonial German forces of the African front of World War I, or the Shutztruppe as they are officially called. The base force of the German presence in East Africa was white German or other Central Power Allied NCOs and senior officers commanding locally enlisted African men, known as the Askari. The Germans typically wore khaki tunics and trousers piped blue with ranks being displayed on the shoulder boards. Headwear in East Africa consisted of primarily a khaki-covered cork tropical helmet bearing the Imperial German cockade on the front. The local Askari troops would wear simple khaki uniforms and trousers with little to no markings and silver buttons, although as the war continued, global civilian wear became used more and more with the Askari as supplies depleted. Webbing for both types of soldier was a mix of older German army webbing and pouches, and new tropical webbing with mini pouches for ammunition lining the sides and bottom. Footwear was also a mix of black marching boots and ankle boots with putties. Another key mark of the Askari troops was the khaki fez. This fez was commonly worn with decorative feathers or a badge on the front signaling their unit. Due to the extreme heat and sun exposure troops faced in Africa, cloth neck protection was key. In South Africa, the land was protected entirely by the German Schutztruppe. Men and officers here wore uniforms very similar to their counterparts in East Africa. However, there were a few key differences between the two forces. The first difference was in the headwear. Instead of the tropical helmet preferred in East Africa, troops in South Africa sported the slouch hat, made famous by the Australian Army. This hat sported the German cockade and could double as a pillow. Unlike other variants, this slouch hat was a light gray color piped blue on the outlines of the hat. Another difference with the South African troops was the equipment. Many troops in South Africa were mounted, and so gear was issued in heavy quantities in order for long rides. This included cavalry swords, mini canteens, extra bandoliers, and such. The Middle Eastern front was very different from both of the other fronts that were covered. The German troops in the Middle East served with the Ottoman troops in defending their territory against British and Anzac forces. Unlike their Schutztruppe counterparts, these troops were called the German Asian Corps and served not only in the early war period, but right up until the Ottoman surrender in October 30, 1918. Their gear and uniform also was much different. The Asian Corps uniform was originally issued in a brown color, but this looked too similar to British troops and was switched to the dark gray of the German army back in Europe. Although the same color, the uniform was different in some parts. First off, the pockets were shaped differently and arranged in a different position than those of the M15 tunic in use in Europe. The shoulder straps were generally khaki, striped white for infantry, red for cavalry, and black for artillery. The headwear consisted of the M16 stall helm generally with a khaki cover on it, or the Ottoman cork helmet. A piece that was very common was also the officer's cap, although since it had a visor unlike the enlisted version, it was used by all ranks. The weaponry of all troops in Africa was mostly the same as in Europe, except without any fancy or advanced weaponry, keeping mostly strictly to rifles and carbines like the Giver 98, Giver 89, C96, and the special Shutztruppe carbine made for them. Alright everyone, that's it for today. Thank you all for watching. Comment down below what you would like me to make next. Please remember to show you support by liking and commenting and ring the notification bell to keep up to date with new videos.